I'm Cassandra Belinsky for Investment Pitch Media. K9 Gold Corp has announced additional multiple mineralized intervals from drilling on its Stony Lake project in central Newfoundland. The Stony Lake property lies within the exploit subzone gold belt of the Cape Ray Valentine Lake structural trend in central Newfoundland, lying parallel to that of Newfound Gold's Queensway project along the prolific Dog Bay line. The project covers 13,625 hectares and 27 kilometers of favorable trend between Sockerman's Moosehead discovery immediately to the northeast and Marathon's Valentine Lake deposit to the southwest. Excellent infrastructure exists on the project lands and in the surrounding area. Today's results are from the remaining drill holes completed on the Jumper's Pond target, which tested the strike and dip extensions of the gold mineralization recently reported from hole JP21012. Hole JP012 intersected 7 intervals of gold mineralization, including 2.58 grams per ton gold over a 3.1 meter core interval with a maximum grade of 4.34 grams per ton gold over a 1 meter core interval. Today's results are from holes JP21019, 20, 21, 22, 23, and 24. Drilled from the same drill pad, have extended the mineralized zone approximately 100 meters along strike to the north. The mineralized intervals in 4 of the drill holes are open and additional sampling is required to determine the full extent of the gold mineralization. JP21022 intersected 12 intervals of gold mineralization, including 65.1 meters averaging 0.78 grams per ton gold from 98.5 to 163.6 meters downhole. Included in JP21022 were intersections of 5.7 meters averaging 2.37 grams per ton gold, 0.7 meters averaging 5.09 grams per ton gold, 18.85 meters averaging 1.22 grams per ton gold and 0.5 meters averaging 5.58 grams per ton gold. We have today with us Chris Healy, Chief Geologist and a Director of K9 Gold, who will discuss the significance of these results. Welcome, Chris.
Thank you, Cassandra. Pleasure to be back here again today. As we reported last week, we had our first really exciting news from the Stony Lake project in central Newfoundland, where we had released results from a drill hole 12 in from our 2021 program, which gave us very exciting results showing multiple wide zones of gold mineralization. Now, this is the first drill program on the project, and to find really good mineralization in hole 12 is really quite exciting. Quite often, you can go 50 or 100 holes before you really get some good results. You're working in an area where there's very little outcrop. You're relying on interpretation of geophysics, interpretation of soil samples. So you don't see anything direct until you drill. Hitting the first few holes, if you hit, that's fantastic, but it's not normally the case. Hitting in hole 12 is really exciting. So since then, we have drilled more holes. We have completed our drilling program with 6 more holes in the same vicinity as hole 12. And if I was excited last week, I'm really excited this week. We have now got 6 more holes, all of which have multiple zones, multiple wide zones of gold mineralization, including 65 meters of continuous gold mineralization in hole 22. All of these holes are targeted around a geophysical anomaly, a chargeability from induced polarization survey we did last year. And that anomaly stretches approximately 3 kilometers. Now, we've drilled just a small portion of that, and we have extended the zone in the order of 100 plus meters along the strike. The widths, as I said, up to 65 meters of continuous downhole mineralization, which is really, really exciting. The grades we're getting are in the order of 1 gram per ton. Now, that is a very interesting value because it is very close to the mineral reserve value that Marathon Gold has reported from their multi-million ounce Valentine Lake project, which is on the same structure, same geological setting as our Stony Lake project. So we're right in the ballpark that we would like to be for developing potentially large tonnage deposit. Now, the grades of 1 gram, those are very common in large scale mines, gold mines around the world. Detour Lake in Ontario runs about 0.9 grams per ton. So we're right in the sweet spot. And I find this to be extremely encouraging. And as a result of this, we are now in the early stages of planning a more expansive program, following up drilling in that same vicinity in the Jumpers Pond. And we will be announcing more details of the program in the coming weeks. So back to you, Cassandra.
Thank you, Chris. Results from the other holes are shown here. The company also owns a 100% interest in the Desert Eagle Vanadium Uranium Project, located in the historic Henry Mountains Mining District in southeast Utah. The area has seen extensive historic vanadium and uranium mining and is close to Anfield Energy Incorporated's Shootering Canyon Mill. The shares are trading at 23 cents. For more information, please visit the company's website, k9goldcorp.com, call 1-833-434-GOLD, that's 4653, contact Costa Tsutsis, director by email at costa@k9goldcorp.com, or contact Brian Morrison, CFO, at brian@k9goldcorp.com. I'm Cassandra Belinsky for Investment Pitch Media.